morning to all. Welcome back to Max Online class. In this video, we are going to solving the problem related to basic proportionality theorem. Exercise number 4.2, question number 2. Look at the diagram. It is a trapezium ABCD. Here, AB which is parallel to CD is given. You know the property of trapezium. Two parallel and two non-parallel straight lines are there. The straight line AP parallel to DC. These two are parallel. This BC and AD are non-parallel straight lines. You know very well. And one more thing. The two points P and Q are on the side AD and BC is given. Two points P and Q are on the sides AD and BC. If you join them, we can get a straight line. It is parallel to the side CD is given. PQ is parallel to DC. If it is parallel to DC, it is also parallel to AB because already AB is parallel to CD is given. Okay. So if CD is parallel to PQ means this PQ is also parallel to AB. I hope you understand this. Here PD length P to D equal to 18 centimeter and BQ, B to Q is equal to 35 centimeter and QC is 15 centimeter. These values are given. They are asking to find the length of AD, length of AD. If you assume A to P length be X centimeter. Okay, this length from A to P equal to X centimeter means AD equal to 18 plus X. Now, length of AD is equal to 18 plus X. Okay, so after finding X value, we want to add with the value 18 after getting value of AD. Okay, so now, join the diagonals A to C, A and C. If you join them, it meets the parallel, it meets the straight line PQ at the point G, at the point G. Okay, so now look at the diagram. Here this triangle ACB, in a triangle ABC, GQ, then this GQ parallel to AB. GQ parallel to AB. By using BPT, basic proportionality theorem. Okay. So we can say that AG by GC equal to BQ by QC. Why should we take basic proportionality theorem? Means the straight line GQ is parallel to the side AB. Okay. So a straight line drawn which is parallel to any one side of the triangle. Okay. It divides the other two sides in the same ratio. That condition. We can write CG by GA is equal to CQ by QB also, no problem. So here I have written AG by GC equal to BQ by QC. If you write from C means CG by GA equal to CQ by QB, okay. So AG, A to G value, we do not know about it. And BQ value, we know that. What is BQ? B to Q is equal to 35 divided by Q to C is equal to 15. Listen, B to Q is equal to 35 and Q to C is equal to 15. So 35 by 15. If you cancel by 5 tables, 7 times, here 3 times. So AG by GC is equal to 7 by 3. Cancel as 1. Okay. So next term, hide this you can take the triangle ACD, okay, or CDA. Here, in a triangle, listen, ACD. ACD, GP is parallel to this side. Okay, in this triangle, this PG is parallel to CD. Okay, so PG parallel to CD by using BPD theorem. Basic proportionality theorem. Okay, so how can we write it? You hide this. AG by GC equal to AP by PD. It is very easy. AG by GC equal to AP by PD. AG by GC equal to AP by PD. You know, AG by GC value, AG by GC equal to 7 by 3. So, substitute AG by GC equal to 7 by 3 in 2. You consider this as 2. Okay. So, AG by GC equal to 7 by 3. That is 1. Substitute here. If you substitute here, 7 by 3 is equal to, what is AP? I assumed AP is equal to X and PD value is given, that is 18. You can cancel it. This is 1 time, this is 6 time. If you add this, what do we get? X is equal to 6 into 7, 42 centimeter. Okay, X value is equal to 42 centimeter. Actually, they are asking to find the value of AD. So, AD equal to 18 plus X value is 42. So, AD is equal to 60 centimeter. This is the required answer. I hope you understand this. See, the trapezium is given and a straight line drawn, which is parallel to any one side. If you draw one side, means it is parallel to the other side also, because AB is parallel to CD is given, and PQ is parallel to CD means this PQ is also parallel to AB. Okay, then you can get one more result from this. Actually, if you join the diagonal, if you join A and C, means you can get it AG by GC equal to BQ by QC. Here AP by PD equal to AG by GC. So AP by PD is equal to BQ by QC. Okay, this is one of the important result. It may help you to solve some problems. Okay, so if you know this result, you can solve this directly. Okay, actually AP by PD equal to BQ by QC. You can write it directly, and AP value is X. AP value is X divided by PD equal to 18 is equal to BQ by QC. BQ is equal to 35 by QC is equal to 15. Okay, so here 5 table means 3 time, here 7 time, here 1 time, 6 time. So X is equal to 42. X is equal to 42, right? So A to D means sum of AP and PD. So 42 plus 18 is equal to 60. So total length is equal to 60 centimeter. Okay, so it is the constant result. So try to keep it in your mind. Exercise number 4.2, question number 4. The question is, from the given diagram, PQ, in the diagram, PQ is parallel to BC. this one is parallel to this one, and PR is parallel to CD. It's PR parallel to CD. Okay, then show that AR by AD equal to AQ by AB. AR by AD is equal to AQ by AB. Okay, so look at the diagram. This straight line QP is parallel to BC, and this one PR is parallel to CD. So first result, we are going to show AR by AD equal to AQ by AB. So if you take the triangle ACD, listen carefully, the left hand side triangle ACD, in a triangle ACD, this PR is parallel to CD. PR is parallel to CD. Therefore, by using basic proportionality theorem, okay, this one, this PR is parallel to the side CD of the triangle ACD. Therefore, it can be written as AP by PC equal to AR by RD. Consider as one. Okay. So next, right hand side. In a right hand side triangle ACB, QP is parallel to BC. Here, by using basic proportionality theorem, AP by PC equal to AQ by QB. Consider as 2. From 1 and 2, both equations have left hand side are equal. AP by PC, here also AP by PC. So equating 1 and 2. What do we get? AP by PC equal to AR by RD. AR by RD is equal to the second one, AP by PC equal to AQ by QB. Okay. So, taking reciprocal on both sides. So RD by AR equal to QB by AQ. Okay. So now applying component rule. What is component rule? If A by B equal to C by D means A plus B by B equal to C plus D by D. This is called the Comonendo rule. So here I applied RD plus AR by, actually by applying Componento rule. What is mean by Componento rule? If A by B equal to C by D means A plus B by B equal to C plus D by D. Actually here this is the numerator, this is the denominator. So we add with the numerator and denominator as it is, like right answer also. Here this is the numerator, this is the denominator. So here I added A plus B by B equal to QB plus AQ by AQ. Okay, so what is this RD plus AR? RD plus AR is equal to AR plus RD equal to the total length, that is AD. Similarly, this AQ plus QB equal to AB. Okay, AQ plus QB equal to AB and AR plus RD equal to AD. So RD plus this RD plus AR equal to AD by AR equal to AB by AQ. So again, taking reciprocal, so we'll get AR by AD equal to AQ by AB. Hence, it is proved. Okay. Exercise number 4.2, question number 4, second subdivision. We have completed first subdivision by using the concept of basic proportionality theorem. Here, PQ is parallel to BC. This PQ is parallel to this side BC, and this PR is parallel to this side CD. Okay, so here we are going to show QB by AQ equal to DR by AR. QB by AQ equal to DR by AR, right? So in a triangle ABC, first I am going to take this. In a triangle ABC, this PQ is parallel to BC. Therefore, by using the concept of basic proportionality theorem, okay, so it says BQ by QA. I hope you understand. BQ by QA equal to CP by PA, right? So BQ by QA, if you take from this vertex, BQ by QA equal to here CP by AP. Okay, consider as 1. Next, in a right triangle ADC, here PR is parallel to CD. This PR is parallel to CD. Therefore, by using the concept of BPT, CP by AP equal to DR by AR. DR by AR. I hope you understand. CP by PA equal to DR by AR. If you redraw the diagram once, means you can understand easily. So for first one, you can draw the triangle ABC, okay, and the second one you can draw this triangle ADC, means you can understand very easily. So here CP by AP equal to BQ by QA, here CP by AP equal to DR by AR. So equating 1 and 2, equating 1 and 2, what do we get? So BQ by QA equal to DR by AR. Actually, what do we want to show? QB by AQ equal to DR by AR. Hence, this BQ is nothing but, listen, this BQ is nothing but QB. We can write it by that QA is equal to AQ, is equal to DR by AR. Hence, it is proved. okay, it is very easy concept. Learn once again. Here PQ is parallel to BC and PR is parallel to CD. Using this concept, then you take first triangle ABC. This PQ is parallel to BC, therefore applying basic proportionality theorem, it means BQ by QA equal to CP by AP or PA. Next, consider this triangle ADC. Here also this PR is parallel to this one CD, therefore CP by PA equal to DR by AR. So from 1 and 2 we can get BQ by QA equal to DR by AR. Hence it is proved. It is one of the 2 mark question. Exercise number 4.2, question number 6. Already we have done this problem. Once again I am going to show the result. Listen, this is the trapezium ABCD parallel to DC. The side AB is parallel to CD and two non-parallel sides are AD and BC respectively, you know very well. We took two points on the side AD and BC, E and F. The two points are E and F. If you join them, they said EF is parallel to AB. If it is parallel to AB, it is parallel to CD. Okay, right. So to show AE by ED equal to BF by FC, by using the concept of basic proportionality theorem. Now, in this triangle ADC, in a triangle, it is not a right triangle, in a triangle ADC, okay, if you join these two vertex, okay, this is the diagonal, you know, AC is the diagonal. If you join them, you can get two triangles, namely ADC and ACB. Okay, so in a triangle ADC, EO, this point, the diagonal AC meets EF at the point O. The diagonal AC meets EF at the point O. Okay, so here EO is parallel to, this one is parallel to this one, you know very well. So OE is parallel to CD. This OE is parallel to CD. By using BPT, AO by OC, AO by OC is equal to AE by ED. That's all. AE by ED. This is one. Next, this triangle ACB. In a triangle ACB, ACB, this OF is parallel to this one, AB. OF is parallel to AB. By using BPT, AO by OC equal to BF by FC. BF by FC. AO by OC is equal to BF by FC. This is two. Listen, why can't we take OC by OA equal to CF by BF? Yes, we can take. After taking OC by OA and CF by BF, we take a reciprocal, okay? So avoiding that term, we can directly take AO by OC equal to BF by FC. It is right. If you take AO by OC is equal to CF by FP, means that is wrong, okay? If you take from this one, means here also you take this. If you take from this vertex, you take OC by OA equal to CF by BF. I hope you understand this. So from 1 and 2, listen, AO by OC equal to AE by ED, equating 1 and 2. Equating 1 and 2, what do we get? Here AO by OC equal to AE by ED. Here AO by OC equal to BF by FC. So when we equate them, what do we get? AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. Okay, so hence AE by ED equal to BF by FC. Hence it is proved.